our Digital Literacy Week, we have stored some activities for you that you will definitely enjoy and you will learn from.
My name is Sumi. Okay. So I'm basically a software engineer, but now due to the passion towards teaching, I'm doing the kids, working as a kids teacher. And our main intention, our company is that eEducation main intention is to introduce all the latest technologies to young kids so that they can innovate, they can bring their own ideas in this platform and they can explore new things.
This screen, it looks like our mobile screen, correct? So the left side screen looks like our mobile screen, and these are the blocks which we are supposed to use. If you click on each of these blocks, see, you are able to see the different color boxes. Okay, so these are our actual tools. We have to play with these tools to develop the game. So here for that we have an inbuilt behaviors. Okay, so this is known as inbuilt. So this is just like our functions. Okay, we already have a set of functions like moving east, moving north, south, all those. So here we have this option called wandering. Can you see this wandering? So it means that moving randomly. So when you click on this edit, you are able to see the set of code behind this wandering function.
So today we very frequently we hear about technologies like artificial intelligence, right? And the reality is that we have already started living in a world which is already having AI in everything what we do in the digital world today. When you have to take the right decision, you need three things. You need to have the right data, right information at the right time so that you'll be able to take the right decision. Otherwise, still you can take the decision, but the decision may not be right if you don't have the right data, if you don't have the right information. Even if you are having the right data and right information, if you're not getting at the right time, the decision may not be right. So you need to have the right data, right information at the right time to take the right decision. Today, analytics and AI, artificial intelligence, is used in drug discovery, health diagnostics, customer service, facial recognition, and even unmanned aerial vehicles, even in drones.
Hey, pay attention now, and don't you dare take your eyes off of me, okay? First of all, let me introduce myself. My name is Kana, and I'm going to be your mentor today. I will be explaining how technology plays its part in preventing the current pandemic.
One factor may include a patient's immunity. A person's immunity is determined by how quickly their immune system takes care of a foreign organism or a substance that invades the body. Factors that may be included is a healthy diet, amount of exercise, and quality of sleep.
Telecommuting. The advancement in technology has allowed education and various occupations to be conducted at the comforts of their homes. Despite social distancing, there are countless benefits from telecommuting.
Hi, we're from Team Adobe and we'll be talking about COVID-19 or the long term of coronavirus and how it has affected businesses, also how the help of computer science can prevent COVID-19. Digital surveillance and facial scan can be used to detect the spread of COVID-19. They can identify infected people, track them, and connect who has contact with them. It can also accurately identify a person and can help monitor someone who is quarantined. It can check people on whether they have come into contact with an infected.
Okay, thank you very much. And we would like to thank also all our dearest homeroom teachers who have keep on encouraging, motivating all the students to join our Digital Literacy Week. We have come to this part wherein we have to say goodbye and end this digital literacy activity. Bye, everyone!